Well, hello, I'm Pastor Don Fugate, and it's my great joy to welcome you to this online version of the 37th annual Christmas Gift to San Jose musical production. You know, we began rehearsing back in September with the hope that we would be able to present it in person. You'd be here in the room, the choir would be on the stage like we have for the previous 36 years. But then the county threw us a curve and they said, well, you can meet indoors, but there can't be any public singing. And so the choir videotaped their performances. We rented a 12-foot by 30-foot video wall, and we were going to present them on that screen, and then the Christmas characters and some of the other characters would be in person to interact with you and yours. Well, then the county threw us another curve and said, no, you can't meet indoors. And so we've had to do some quick re-editing, and this has become an online performance. But I believe God can use it in a wonderful way to share hope, joy, peace, all that we celebrate about this great season of Christmas. And if Christmas is about nothing else, it's about hope. Hope for a better day coming, hope for a better year in 2021, and hope that is found in a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. And so before the choir begins performing for you tonight, let's commit this time to the Lord in prayer. Would you pray with me, please? Our Father and our God, I thank you for every person who is watching this presentation today. God, I pray that you'll just bless them this Christmas. I pray you will protect them and their families, that you'll provide for them, and that even in this tough year, God, that this could be the most significant Christmas of our lifetimes. And so, Lord, I pray that these songs will honor you, and I pray that they will communicate the joy we have that's found in that personal relationship. Bless us in this performance and in this presentation. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, grab some popcorn or some hot chocolate. Get ready to be blessed. Sing along with the songs if you know them, and enjoy the Christmas Gift to San Jose musical production. I'll see you at the end of the performance.
a little snow, a little snow. Here comes Christmas, bells are ringing, lights are shining, kids are singing. Here comes Christmas, lights are longing, streets are crowding. There's a song of joy in this heart of mine, and I can't help but smile to find. Here comes Christmas time. Christmas time. There's a thrill so familiar that rides the winter wind, that suddenly makes folks like me feel like kids again. Oh, here comes Christmas, bells are ringing, lights are shining, kids are singing. Here comes Christmas, lines are longer, streets are crowded, there's a song of here comes Christmas, bells are ringing, lights are shining, kids are singing. Here comes Christmas, lines are longer, streets are crowded, there's a song of joy in this heart of mine, and I can't help but smile to find.
tingling too. Come on, it's a lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you. Outside the snow is falling and friends are calling you. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you. Well, that's right. Our cheeks are nice and rosy and comfy cozy are we. We snuggle close together like two birds of a feather would be. Let's take that road before us and sing a chorus or two. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
For the holidays, you can't be home sweet home. Ahoy, everybody! SpongeBob here. Christmas means presents and mistletoe, sharing and caring. So during this festive season, please, don't be a jerk.
Bring joy to the world, it's the thing to do. But the world does not revolve around you. Don't be a jerk. It's Christmas. There's a sign above the line that says express. That means 10 items or less. Don't be a jerk.
Don't be a jerk.
It's Christmas. Be nice to babies and animals. Oh, folks too.
on, build a snowman. Come on, let's go and play. I never see you anymore. Come out the door, it's like you've gone away. We used to be best buddies, and now we're not. I wish you could tell me why. Do you want to build a snowman? Doesn't have to be a snowman. Okay, bye.
A holly jolly soul with a corncob pipe and a button nose and two eyes made out of coal.
Frosty the Snowman
is a fairy tale, they say. He was made of snow, but the children know how he came to life one day. Oh, there must have been some magic in that old silk hat they found. For when they placed it on his head, he began to dance around. Oh, Frosty the Snowman had to hurry on his way. But he waved goodbye saying, "Don't you cry, I'll be back again someday."
Everybody needs a Christmas sweater. Christmas friends are the best. They're festive and they're neat, and no outfit is complete without some Merry Christmas on your chest.
There's nothing better than the store sweater, bedazzled and glamour just for you. Any kind of thing you can imagine can be made with yarn and tinsel and some blue. Everybody needs a Christmas sweater. Ugly Christmas sweaters are the best. They're festive and they're neat, and no outfit is complete without some Merry Christmas on your chest. They're festive and they're neat, and no outfit is complete without some Merry Christmas on your chest. Oh, ugly Christmas sweaters are the best.
Jesus. Behold, come all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. Oh, come ye, oh, come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. Oh, come, let us adore.
Sky is the same that appeared and the wise men revealed when hope was born this night. Out upon the snowy fields, there's a silent peace that heals, and it echoes the grace of our Savior's embrace when hope was born this night. Christmas bells ring as softly a church choir sings. It's as the song used to praise the ancient days when hope was born this night. There are angels in this place, and my heart resounds with praise. Like a shepherd so scared, I'll rejoice and declare that hope was born this night. Because hope was born this night. Gloria, 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 oh glory.
Behold, a virgin shall conceive and shall bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Emmanuel, meaning God with us. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end upon the throne of his father David. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will accomplish this.
Differently. But I believe that miracles can still happen. Just when it seems impossible, the unexpected happens when you least expect it. Once upon a time, on a dark and cold winter's night, I saw a bright star shining from the east. And I followed it.
Oh.
all of the sudden, an angel of the Lord appeared and said, "Do not be afraid. I bring good news of great joy for all mankind. Today, a Savior has been born to you, and he is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign to you. You will find this baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace to those on whom his favor rests."
Thank you. day. It's not just about the shepherds or the bright and shining star. It's not all about the wise men who travel from afar. It's about the cross. It's about my sin. It's about how Jesus came to be born once so that we could be born again. It's about the stone that was rolled away so that you and I could have real life someday. It's about the cross. It's not just about the presence underneath the tree. It's not all about the feeling that the season brings to me. It's not just about coming home to be with those you love. It's not all about the beauty and snow I'm dreaming of. It's about came to be born once so that we could be born again. It's about the soul that was rolled away so that you and I could have real life someday. It's about the cross, the beginning of the story is wonderful and why we celebrate. It's about the cross. It's about my sin. It's about how Jesus came to be born once so that we could be born again. It's about God's Son nailed to a tree. It's about every drop of blood that flowed from Him when it should have been me. It's about the soul that was rolled away so that you and I could have real life someday. So that you and I could have real life someday.
Well, we have one more song to present to you for the Christmas gift to San Jose. I hope you've enjoyed the program, the variety of it, seeing all your favorite Christmas characters. But more than that, I pray that you have found yourself transported to a manger in Bethlehem to adore Jesus Christ, the King of Kings. Even though he came as a humble baby, that's just the beginning of the story. The Bible says he went around during his life doing good. He gave sight to the blind. He made the crippled walk again. The Bible says he even raised the dead. But the greatest demonstration of his power and his love was when he voluntarily went to the cross, one of the cruelest punishments known to mankind. And on that cross, Jesus, who John the Baptist called the Lamb of God, laid his life down for you and for me. God placed on Jesus on that cross your sin and my sin, and the sins of the whole world for all time, once and for all. You may say, how could God do it? Well, Jesus is an infinite being. And so in just those 3 short hours, he had the ability, the capacity to take on all of my sins and all of your sins for all time. And so now what separates a sinful man from a relationship with a holy God is not your sins. Jesus dealt with that. What separates you is this. What have you done with Jesus? Jesus stands before your life right now, spiritually speaking. And Revelation 3:20 says this. Jesus says, I stand at the door and knock. Do you hear that? He may be knocking on the door of your life. And he said, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come in to him and fellowship with him and he with me. You see, Jesus is a gentleman. He doesn't force himself on anybody. He comes in only by invitation. And so I want to ask you before we close tonight, is there any good reason why you wouldn't say yes to love, yes to life, yes to forgiveness, yes to Jesus, yes to the greatest gift of Christmas? You see, the greatest gift of Christmas is not to be found under a tree. The greatest gift of Christmas is found in a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. And if I could give you a gift today, it would be to encourage you, say yes to Jesus today. If that's your desire, even though we're separated across the miles, it's as simply as asking. Just say this, dear Jesus, I need you. And I know I'm a sinner. And so if you'd like to settle that issue, I want to lead you through what we call a sinner's prayer. And if you just pray these words after me, something marvelous could happen. Would you pray with me, please? Just say this, dear Jesus, I know I'm a sinner, but I thank you that you love sinners just like me. Today, I ask you to come into my life and forgive my sins and be my Lord and Savior, and I will live for you and follow you. Jesus, I believe what the Bible says about you, that you died on the cross for my sins, that you were buried in a grave that would hold me forever, and that you were raised again on the third day. I believe that, and I receive you as my Savior today. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Well, my friend, if you prayed that prayer with a heart of faith and sincerity, then I can assure you upon the authority of God's word that your sins are forgiven, that you're a new person, a new creation in Jesus Christ. The old is gone, the new has come. You've just received the greatest gift of this or any Christmas. And so celebrate, tell somebody, I've received Jesus Christ as my Lord and my Savior. Tell me, would you let me know about it? Send me an email and just say, Pastor Don, I received Jesus today. You can send that email to PastorDon@foxworthy.org. And if you will, I'll send you a little booklet that will help you begin this new life in Jesus Christ. It will talk to you about your identity in Christ. It will talk to you about prayer. What's prayer all about? Well, it's talking to God like you would a dear friend. It'll talk to you about your Bible. That's God's love letter to you, and you need to start, I would say, in the Gospel of John, reading about Jesus. And then it'll talk to you about church. And you know, one of these days, they'll lift the stay-at-home order, and we'll be able to gather here person to person. What a day it will be of rejoicing. And I would love to celebrate with you your decision for Jesus Christ, and perhaps celebrate your baptism. Well, my friend, may the Lord richly bless you. May this be one of the most beautiful Christmases of your life. God bless you.
Heart and soul and voice, telling good news. to bring. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Just sing.